An explanatory variable in a regression model is defined as the change in the mean response when the explanatory variable is increased by 1, holding all the other variables in the model constant. Let's take this example. We have the following model. The mean of y as a function of x1 and x2 is beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. The effect of x1 is going to be a difference between two means. So we're trying to capture the change in mean. So the first mean we're going to look at is the mean of y when x1 is increased by 1. So we kind of have to specify what it's being increased from. We're going to say it was the value little x and it is increased by 1. We're holding all the other variables constant. So in this model there is also x2 and we're not going to change its value. So this is the mean response when x1 is little x plus 1. We want to compare that to the mean of the response when x1 takes its original value, little x. And again, x2 isn't changing, so we'll leave it as in the model. So this is simply a symbolic representation of the change in mean when x1 is increased by 1. By definition, that is the effect of x1. So now we can substitute in our regression model and figure out what this value is. So let's take this first one. Whenever we see an x1 in our regression model, we're going to put in a lowercase x plus 1. So we have beta 0 plus beta 1. Here's an x1, so I'm going to substitute in little x plus 1 plus beta 2 times x2. And then I'm going to subtract off the other mean. Wherever I've got an x1, in this case I'm going to put in a lowercase x. I have beta 0 plus beta 1 times little x plus beta 2 times x2. Okay, so I'm going to, before I do the subtraction, I'm going to multiply out this first term. So I have a beta 0 plus beta 1 times x plus beta 1 times 1. That's beta 1. Plus beta 2 x2. And that's all I need to simplify out. I'm just going to repeat this one here. Beta 0 plus beta 1 x plus beta 2 x2. Okay, so now I can do the subtraction. Beta 0 minus beta 0, that's going to be 0. Beta 1x minus beta 1x, that's 0. Beta 2x2 minus beta 2x2, that's also 0. The only thing left is this beta 1. So in this particular model, the effect of x1 is beta 1. So if x1 increases by a unit, the change in mean is beta 1 units.